push him away from me. Okay, so I'm gonna trap with this leg, the leg that's flat, I'm gonna use it as a ramp to bring it over. Now I put, keep my arms stiff, I'll come here, Cal. My arms are stiff, still, so he can't come up on me. I take this leg out, I turn, and I figure for my leg. Okay? All right, same thing. Again, I don't wanna put my arms out because he'll get an arm bar, right? Exactly, he'll trap. I always wanna keep my elbows in tight and start to shimmy my way away from him. I wanna, this leg goes down, this leg posts, but I stiff arm him hard, boom. Now I take this leg here and I use it as a ramp off my other leg. So which leg has to be down? This one. So now I turn my hips, switch it,
figure for my legs. Make sense?
Yes.
Perfect.
Yep. Or it's like this. Why? Because I wanna bump him. So as I bump, now I trap this leg. So now, look, I don't let this leg go. So I start to pinch and I turn into him. I wanna get the trap high up on his quad. Okay? Zach is higher up on you. So if I trap him here, all he has to do is pull his leg from this way. Yeah, he pulls his leg out, right? So when I trap him, I want to trap like a vice grip in his quad, okay? So now I can, just to show you guys why I do that, is now as I sit up, now I can start to attack. See, now I end up in this position. Boom. So now I'm inside. Make sense? Mm-hmm. So if you're on the bottom, if you guys, it's going to be a scramble. So if I do it around his ankle, right? So let's say I trap here. Now I come up. Now he pushes back down on me with his knee. Yes! Now I'm back into that same horrible position I was originally in. Where if I'm higher up on his thigh, and I'm here, he can't push into me. See that? Look, he can't. I got the leverage. So now I get the sweep. Right? Okay? So, the leg on the outside is flat. This foot is as close to my butt. I stiff arm him. I trap. I turn. Now I can start to watch. I can go here, sweep him, multiple attacks in that position. Okay? Okay? I don't want him to cross face me. So it's the same thing like in side position. I always want to defend here. Okay? If he starts to come around and chokes me, you gotta make sure that you're defending the arm. So I like to hold around his waist here. Okay? So again, what you can do is you can shuck him this way, come out, right? And then take his back. Okay, you got one thing there. You got that position, right? But what we're gonna do here is we're just gonna do the first one. We don't need
okay.
Just stay up here. What I wanna do here is I'm gonna trap this leg with this foot here, boom. So now, look at me. I'm gonna close with this arm, I'm gonna come up here, and I still have his leg, so he can't pull it out. I'm gonna take his knee here, and I'm gonna pull him into me. So now I'm in this position. As I reach, I pull myself up and I start to mount it and turn his face in the opposite direction. When you start to reach around his face, you want to take your shoulder and move him in the opposite direction. So I end up on mount with that sweep. So I started off in a bad position, then I get in a good position, right? So it's from a different angle, right? So we end up in half guard. Boom. This way, right? So I'm here. So this is what I don't want him. Once he starts to post that knee down, I'm in trouble. Okay, so there's different scenarios here. So I don't want, that's why I want to ride him up high. So I'm here. So I'm going to reach, and I'm going to kick this leg here, and I'm going to track. Look, my outside leg tracks his heel, and I come up here. So look, I'm on both my knees. So look at the position that he's in. So now I'm going to cup his leg and cup his ankle and pull him into me. But look at the pressure that I'm pulling. So what I want to do is I bring his arm here, and I reach around his neck, so now I can start to walk up his here. If he's here, no problem. Look what I do, guys. Head and arm triangle, right? Head and arm choke. If he does this mistake, I'm just going to trap the arm, figure four my arms, and squeeze. More likely he's not, so now I'm in this position. When I'm here, I scoop the head, and I want to turn him into the opposite direction. So now he's going to defend it with this hand, pushing on you here.
Good.
So now I bring it across. Boom. Now look what I got. I got the arm bar. Right? So the reason why you do things is to get a reaction from him.
Makes sense? I know it's a little complicated.
So exactly. So now I want to get here and I post this leg here and I switch. So now look, I still figure for this leg. Okay? So there's a couple things. I can come down here, drive, lift, and get me. So look at this, right? If his leg is flat, I drive my hips to his knee, I lift up on his ankle, still figure for my legs, and I drive his knee down, right? I don't know what you guys doing that, we'll show that in a more advanced class. Okay, but I just want to let you know why that figure four is important. Okay, so I'm here. So I don't want him to figure four this leg. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let go of this leg, and I'm going to take it off with this leg. So see the pressure I have here. Now I'm going to take this leg over, and once I feel like I passed, I can now take this leg off. My elbow comes into his hip, my hand comes up to his head, and I sit on my heels. And I keep this side position. I call him pushing down. Switch, pass, step. Take the hand out, cross face, pull them into you, sit back.
Where do you get
so what happens is in the wizard. So switch, you get in this position. I'll show you why he's gonna wizard me. So if I'm here and he's got this on the hook, what I wanna do is I wanna go for a Gosh choke, right? So I can start the choking here. So this is a choke, right? So I'm gonna wizard. So in jiu-jitsu, you can do a Gosh choke where I literally grab my hands, take my elbow, and lock it. Look how I lock it, and I choke him, right? So I don't want him to do that to me, okay? So in the scenario, if he's deeper, which he should be, it lets me get that. See how that does that? Or I can come here and squeeze this. But I like this choke because it's nasty, right? So I want to crank on him. It's called a Darsh choke. And it's very common, so you can drive here, and it's just on, right? So how you defend that, if it happens, because once you start getting more advanced and you teach that stuff, is now he starts to wizard me here, exactly. So watch what I do. I defend it by cupping his wrist. So now he has no base on his side. Same thing. That's how I defend it. I just take that out of the equation. Make sense? So I neutralize it by just he comes and he guard chokes me on deep. He wants to start doing this. I just cup his hand, right? So I trap his hand. Cal, come around and look. So I stop it. Now, he has no base on this side whatsoever. Watch. Look how easy it is for me, right? So I just come around. Now I end up in a better position. Sit through in a scarf hold, start to attack, right? Arm bars, things like that, right? So you have a different center. So I just want you to know that that's there to do that quickly, right? And then we're gonna go into the next move. I don't want you to take a lot of time on